looking stupid on the stoop.
Oh my goodness.
I would take notes if I were you.
Oh my goodness.
This was designed with the stars, the square and the cross, so we know true north.
Oh my goodness.
Smiling with 50 carats in my jaw.
Oh my goodness.
The law is a shame, rhyme.
Young Dick the diamonds, finest. I shine like Puff shine. Shines if I sign to the rock, cause I'm timeless. Top off the Mozzie, my behavior is mindless. On kids, we major, you mindless. Fresh out the cell to the booth. Drop the booth. I'm still in the hood, tell, shoot. Hope with a club. The judge, you rappers is false flagging, you a fashion. What's cuz, what you know about? What's Velo? Why Barry Lee, your head ringing? Free Vic Mensa, I'm a star, chain swinging. This tech music, you can blame Reagan. I'm ball man without paying. Y'all playing, we playing. My Himalayan, the lotto, that's a sacrificial lamb. I'm season cam, no matter, blam.
Pulling up with the coupe.
Oh my goodness.
Must have done same with the roof.
Oh my goodness.
You sitting looking stupid on the stoop.
Oh my goodness.
I would take notes if I were you.
Oh my goodness.
This was designed with the stars, the square and the cross, so we know true north.
Oh my goodness.
Smiling with 50 carats in my jaw.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
The law. It's a shame, rhyme, crime.
Every other night I'm outside with the. You ain't got chips. Chip the world, you got chips. You could put the next man's girl. Sounds harsh, but they been ripped apart my world. The way Kiss told it should never be misquoted. No. The that you wave on the camera, we.
Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned into the NFL on EA Sports. Squaring off today, we have two teams who come in with identical records on the season. It's the Bills going up against the Bengals.
From the banks of the Ohio River, there's a look at Paul Brown Stadium here in Cincinnati, Ohio. This crowd loves their orange and black. The scene just a short time ago, they were in full roar as their guys burst out of the locker room. We're ready for football as the Bengals get set to do battle with the Buffalo Bills. The first quarter of the season already in the rearview mirror, and off we go in week 5 on EA Sports. Now Tre'Davious White on the return. And he'll take this across the 25, couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The 40 and cuts out right sideline, and he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line. So it'll be first down here after the run. From the gun, here's Goff. Left side here, caught by Clay. And heavy contact. He is knocked down hard. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. They'll run it with Jones, fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. And he got half of what he needed there, 2 yards, and it'll bring up a third and two more. And the defense searches for one more stop here after the run on second down. Off play action, here's Goff. Gets it to Benjamin. It's caught. And all the way home for a Bills touchdown. Kelvin Benjamin, his second touchdown on the season, and the Bills have taken the early lead. Steven Hauschka for the point after. And it's 7-0 Buffalo. Here's Hauschka now to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Now the rookie from Oklahoma, it's Joe Mixon. And oh, right away, he lost the football. Now this is picked up by the Bills. And he'll take this down inside the 15-yard line. Well, he's going to have to shake out the cobwebs first time he touches the football, and he drops it on the ground.
So many times we talk about quarterbacks and taking care of them early to get them in the flow with safe throws, right? But with a runner, there is no such thing as a safe run, right? Right out of the gate, you're going to be in some traffic. Got to take care of the ball, and he didn't do that.
See what Dalton can do after the fumble recovery. This one grabbed by A.J. Green. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down. A first down throw coming for Dalton. Room to run past midfield. Throwing the out route incomplete. That's Green. Give him 17 and a Cincinnati first down.
I like that one, partner. They go back to back with excellent gains, and really it shouldn't be a surprise who they were throwing the ball to. He's their best guy.
Yeah, we knew that they would get him involved early. They're doubling down on getting him involved early.
Don't be surprised if they'll come right back to him again. They haven't shown the propensity to be able to stop him.
Dalton, first and 10. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and it'll bring up a second down. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. Dalton with a give here to Mixon. And able to push forward for right around 3 yards down to the 42.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things. But the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
They'll stay on the ground. Mixon again. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. Now they run with Mixon, and the play goes nowhere, losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. So add that tackle for a loss to the 2 that he had a week ago.
And you know what he's doing right now?
Smiling?
Yeah, definitely doing that. But he's also patting his guys on the back, his defensive front, because they're keeping him clean, meaning no one's getting to him as a blocker. He's able to run to the football, and the plays he's making, he's spilling them in the offensive backfield.
He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and they'll be facing a 3rd and 12. the gun. Dalton looks to throw. Forced out to his left. Brought in here by Tyler Eifert. And he's able to pick up the first down here before he goes down at the 26. Dalton to his big target, Eifert, for the Cincinnati first. And the eighth play on this drive coming up. Defense offsides here. Freebie for Dalton. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. So a first down and five for the offense. They'll run it now out of the gun. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
Joe Mixon plays up to his potential. Cincinnati got a draft steal getting him in the second round.
Strong runner. He's built like a rock, 230 pounds.
Yeah, and he moves like a little guy. All right, he's one of those players that you can use in any situation. Short yardage runner, heck, you want to get him to the perimeter, he can take off and beat you with his speed and definitely catches the ball out of the backfield.
Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin, and it's the Bengals with the football to begin quarter number two. And they're on the move as they face a second down here. And the seemingly endless drive continues. They'll run it now out of the gun. And this play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back to the 15. It's a loss of two. Now third down.
Partner, you mind if I take off this headset and put on a coaching headset?
You want to get this running game going?
I want to get this running game going. I'm going down there and saying, gentlemen, we have got to run the football. We've got to get it going right now.
Yeah, to this point in the second quarter, it has been a struggle. Third down, a shot here for Dalton. Flush to his right. Underneath, this is Bernard. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and that'll bring up fourth down. And Bullock will put this one through, and they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So they get three. They were hoping for six, an unlucky number 13 play drive.
Well, you go to the sideline after putting 3 points on the board, happy, but you wanted to be ecstatic. You wanted to have six on the board. On the opposite sideline, though, the defense, I think they're high-fiving each other, only giving up three after letting them run that much offense.
And coming up later tonight in the NFL, we'll have the Chiefs heading down to Houston to take on the Texans. And then on Monday night, it'll be an NFC North battle. Vikings and Bears from Soldier Field.
Traditional rivals getting after it one more time.
He'll start on the ground with McCoy. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
So when you call a corner blitz, what a lot of teams call a cat blitz, you're expected to come after the quarterback. But in this case, he ran into the ball carrier. Really nice technique, because what you do is you come deep as the deepest offensive player so he can't get outside of you.
On second down, here's Goff. Steps away to his left. Room here to run. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. 16 yards there, and the Bills have a first down.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
Now a first down carry here for McCoy. And he's across the 40, three extra yards to the 43. And give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action and hit them over the top.
They'll try the air now with Gall. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. They'll give him a yard on the play, and they're going to face a third down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Play action. It's gone. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Pressure, and that's certainly going to be a key to this game going forward. And that time, they were able to get in there and influence the throw. And remember, quarterbacks got to get rid of it. They don't have the tucker rule that they can fall back on anymore.
And he gets it away. A directional kick going toward the sideline. No returning this one. It sails out of bounds. And they'll spot it right at the 20. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points?
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that would help him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Toe bashed it.
Super toe.
It's a gain of 8, and it's going to take us to the 2-minute warning. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. We'll come back to Cincinnati after this. Again, it's Mixon, and not a whole lot doing there as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. Only a yard on the pickup, so from a good situation on second and two, it's now 3rd and 1. Now Mixon, and he gets it to the 32, good enough for a first down. It's a gain of 4 there, and it gives him a new set of downs.
3rd and 1, partner. No need to be fancy there. Just use some force and move forward and pick up the first down.
Dalton bootlegs out. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. It's a 4-yard pickup, and it'll make it 2nd down.
And when you have a guy in the backfield who can catch the football, you don't just use him strictly for checkdowns or dump-offs. You make him part of the primary passing attack because what you're trying to do is get him into open field and then let him make people miss and advance the football.
They'll run here with Mixon. And hard running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42. It's a 6-yard run, leaves him with about a foot or so here still to go to hit the marker with 3rd down coming up. Mixon, and he's got the 1st down yardage as he brings this up to the 47. And now before this 1st down play, we're going to get a timeout here as he'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the 1st down. So the run moves the chains, and here we go on 1st down. Out of the gun, it's Dalton. And the Bills are going to get him as he goes down. Jerry Hughes in there to drop him for his 5th sack of the year. Dalton throwing on 2nd down. He's going to rifle one deep left side into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 30. And he will take this across midfield and down to the 48-yard line.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
Cooper! so the D-line's going to spread out. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be taken down right around the 41-yard line. Now before this second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout, as it'll come with 36 ticks to go in half number one. Here's Goff now on second down. He finds McCoy. A big hit. Knocked down sideways. And now prior to this third and one, we're going to get a timeout here, as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play. This is third and one, very likely four down territory, even if they don't get it, though. Goff now looking to throw. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. It goes as a gain of eight, and it moves the chains.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
On first down, it's gone. He's got a man complete. It's Clay. And he's going to be out of bounds down inside the 20. 11 yards and a Buffalo first down.
Nice job. Nice patience right there. Put him on the right side. Let him work his way across. Put the ball in his hands and let him work his way upfield with a catch.
And now inside the red zone, the offense will operate. On first and 10, Goff. And Jones has it over the middle. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead, as they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number one. First and goal at the 3-yard line now. Again, Goff. Free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
It's a lot of contact going on there, and in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. So on second down, the field goal unit is on here as they try to get 3 before half. This a chip shot, a 20-yarder. And Hauschka's kick is good. And we'll get our first update of the afternoon from the Meadowlands. It's the Chargers out to an early lead. I have a feeling that one's going to stay tight throughout. We'll continue to monitor. Now after the made field goal, Hauschka back out onto the field to kick it away. Returning it, John Ross. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Now the Cincinnati offense ready to see what they can do here. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
And an alley to run. And they're able to get this one across the 35. So we've reached halftime with the visiting Bills taking the... Sorry, Larry. Your hard work appreciated by so many men and women, but not today as we get back to the action in the second half. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. This will be fielded at the 6. And a pretty slick return there as he's up just shy of the 45-yard line.
That strong return has set them up nicely for this drive, and we all know the next score is going to have a major impact on this game.
Yeah. They'll start here with a give to Mixon. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't throw up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. A gain of four on the play, and that'll bring up a third down. Dalton here from the gun. And Eifert has it. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. 10 yards there on a Bengal first. On first and 10, here's Andy Dalton.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down.
A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
Only a yard on the pickup there, so it leaves them needing a conversion here on third and a tough nine. Dancing to his left. He may try and run for this. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. 12 yards that time and a Cincinnati first down.
Obviously a big play was needed. And you can see his eyes light up as he realized there's absolutely no one in front of him. And he takes off and goes a long way. Not only does he pick up a first down, but a big gain to boot.
Now Dalton with a first and 10. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets this down about the 21 or 22. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
They'll run it now out of the gun, and they'll get him down right about the 20. 2 yards the gain there, and now they're left with a third and about four for a first.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
Third down from the gun, Dalton. And able to find Green. And he is out of bounds right around the 10-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. I don't know what they talked about at halftime. Whatever it was, it worked. They look like a different team here in the third quarter.
Yeah, I doubt that there were very many trash cans that got kicked over that type of a speech. I think what they did was they analyzed what worked in the first half.
And he will take it on in for a Bengals touchdown. Giovanni Bernard, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Bengals are an extra point away from tying up this football game. And he'll bang that one through. So all square here in this third quarter as the kick's away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. So here's the Bills offense. Now they get ready for their first possession of the second half. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
And a big hit there as he runs into a brick wall at the 33. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and two. See if they stay on the ground for second down. Now a play fake, and it's gone. And he'll be taken down by the Bengal pressure. Carlos Dunlap in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8. The Bills on third down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 10. A shotgun snap for Goff. Now that'll be tipped and intercepted. Picked off by George Iloka. And they get the football. They'll set up shop at their own 49-yard line.
This interception will go on the record of the quarterback. But as a receiver, you've got to understand where you are in the field. Middle portion, you know it's going to come in hot. Square your body to the quarterback and be ready to make the catch.
The drive will commence with a run by Mixon. And he's going to take this one down inside the 45. And that is not a sight they want to see. Joe Mixon, very slow to get up. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Dalton gives to Bernard. And he'll be brought down at about the 42. Give him a yard on the run there, and that's going to set up a 3rd down and 2. Again, here's Bernard. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well. So here we go, 1st and 10 now. They go play action here on 1st down. And this one's incomplete. His big tight end, Tyler Eifert, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up 2nd down.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. And he'll get 3 down to the 34-yard line. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on 3rd down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
Now the Bengals on 3rd down. They've been flat, getting it done. 8 for 9 to this point. This is 3rd and 7. Again with Bernard, and he'll go down at the 28. He's just short. He got 6 of the 7 he needed, so that leaves a decision here on 4th and a yard. So out comes the field goal team now for the 2nd time here today. He made his first attempt, this from 45. And this one is right down Broadway. A 3rd quarter score now from MetLife Stadium. And you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. Remember to keep an eye on the ticker, of course, at the bottom of your screen for updates on that game and others around the NFL. The Bills getting set to go. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
They want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. He'll be tackled shy of the 35. Shifty footwork gets him a little extra on the play. For McCoy, in the last 7 years, 5 of them over 1,000 yards.
Underrated in how strong he is through the hole, but the best part of his game, open field, where he makes a whole lot of people miss.
In 2016, he was 7th in the league in rushing yardage. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. From the 50, it's gone. And he'll check this one down to McCoy. 20! And oh, so close as he takes it all the way to the 2-yard line. A big play here for the Bills. 48 yards. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's 1st and goal. They come out here in the eye. They'll try and run it with McCoy. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal.
Well, he did get a taste the previous week. He got into the end zone, trying his best to get there. And
he'll get in. Touchdown, Buffalo. LeSean McCoy, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Bills have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter. Solid job up front. Really just a solid job all the way around to get that one in.
That was well executed, wasn't it? Well blocked, well run. End result, 6 points.
Touchdown. Here's Hauschka now to kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Bengals offense now, they head back onto the field. And last time able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just, I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. It's a 6 yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and four.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and four and second and eight and nine.
12 yards that time and a Cincinnati first down.
For so many years, I was convinced it was a myth. You know, because you always hear about the smaller running back, but he gets lost, you can't find him, and sometimes that's part of his genius. But it's true. You get behind big offensive linemen, the defensive line guys trying to find him, trying to peek around people to see him, and he gets lost. But this guy gets lost in a good way for his offense, picking up big yardage.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. They'll run it now out of the gun. They're able to push forward for about four down to the 37.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here, because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last four plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, four plays in this drive, all four on the ground. Hill shedding the tackle, and all the way in for a Cincinnati score. Jeremy Hill, his first touchdown on the year. And the Bengals have taken the lead here in the fourth.
Well, pardon me, that was another explosive run, and one thing I've learned in our time in this game, yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit, but for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to block well downfield.
And then you have to have a good guy carrying the ball too, right?
Oh, without a doubt. You need that difference maker lugging the rock.
Set to return now. Here's Deontay Thompson. And it's a pretty good return here, as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. The Bills' offense now, they get set to head back onto the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Oh, he's got a little daylight. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out. And by a few inches, that'll be a first down.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed. And he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
Left side here, caught by Clay. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
Such a valuable commodity to have a tight end who can run and get open. How about what he just did there? Worked his way from right to left across the field and found his way free.
Now a first down throw. Gone. Oh, no, he lost the football.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
And, of course, the quarterback in this situation, he's realizing time is becoming a factor. Let's see if they can get some points on the board here late. The throw on second down is gone. And incomplete on the deep ball. They were looking to get it to Kelvin Benjamin there. And it's third down.
The effort's always going to be there. Everyone's always going to try and make a catch, but underthrown balls, I think, are the toughest ones to come back and get because usually your momentum's going in the opposite direction when you're trying to stop, break, and come back and get it.
Third and long. It's gone. Eluding the pressure right. Gets it to Benjamin. It's caught. He got 29 yards that time. Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. Shift together here from the D-line. 10th carry now for McCoy. And down inside the 15 he goes. 11 more on that one and another first down. And now all of a sudden the shoe's kind of on the other foot. Maybe you pull the reins back here a bit?
Yeah, a little bit because you got to make sure that you don't score too quickly.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. And they'll keep on the ground with McCoy. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. And now the Bengal defense here calling a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Second down following the run. They'll look to throw. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Carlos Dunlap in there to take him down. And the clock will roll. The Bills on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is third and 16. Back to throw. And that is incomplete.
I think that was a good job there defensively. They did allow him to drive all the way downfield, but once they got their backs to the goal line, they really turned up the pressure.
Yeah, they let him get all the way down here. Now the field shrinks. They've struggled to convert, and that last incompletion brings up fourth. And Hauschka's kick is good. Elsewhere, they're onto the fourth quarter of MetLife Stadium. The Chargers have scored again, so they open up a 2-touchdown lead. If they hang on, that would up their win total to 5 on the season so far. So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And out now, here come the Bengals. They've got work to do, but they do still have a bit of time here.
And they've got to feel comfortable with that, but they have all their play sequences called. They get out of bounds, that allows them to huddle and call another play. But if they don't, it's hurry up to the line of scrimmage and either spike it and stop the clock or continue to move it downfield in order to try and get in range and win this game.
And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. And now the Bills are going to stop it as they call a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Well, timeout on their side here. In fact, a lot going against them. They do have a small glimmer of hope.
No one likes to play extra football. They want to go for the win right now.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get this one across the 20, but only up to about the 21. Only 2 yards on the pickup there, and now they're looking at a long third down. Now the Bills will take another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play.
And the Bengals on third down. They've been tough to stop. 8 for 10 so far. This is third and 14. They'll run it now out of the gun. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down. Now here's a whistle and a timeout. It's called by the receiving team here. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. And the win last week punted four times as this one's away. And running with power here. It'll be a net of 40 yards following a punt of 44. And the Bills will take over the football with a first and 10. The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. Now it's gone. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Carl Lawson in there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon. Now gone. Complete with 11 seconds remaining now. Back-to-back big plays defensively. First the sack. Now they force the incompletion on third and long. Things looking pretty good for them.
And this is where they have to be careful because they've got the momentum going their way. They will be really amped up to get to the quarterback. Look out. Draw, screen, something that can be used against them.
Goff now to throw. Looking downfield for Jones. And that is intercepted on the sideline. Wait, no. They'll say no. It was caught out of bounds. So this is just an incompletion here. Here's Colton Schmidt now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. Taken in at the 11. Fighting him off. Elsewhere, they're on to the fourth quarter at MetLife Stadium. And here in overtime, if the team that receives the ball scores a touchdown, it's over. If they don't, we could still have some more football.
That's exactly right. If they go down and kick a field goal, the other team gets a possession to either match it or score a touchdown to win the ball game. If both teams kick field goals, the next team to score wins. But if the receiving team throws a pick six or fumbles the ball and it gets picked up by the defense and they score, the game is over at that point.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Bengals getting set to go. They control their own destiny here. They have the football in overtime. Obviously, a touchdown would win it.
And I think teams around the league are still adjusting to the idea of going downfield, scoring a touchdown wins the game because they were used to just going downfield and trying to get in field goal range to win a game. Still having to make that transition. Let's face it now, the ones who are doing it best know they need to go down, attack, put the ball in the end zone, and not leave it up to a field goal and give the other team a chance.
Yeah, as we said, they control their own destiny now. And ready now for second and 9. So now the first OT throw coming for Dalton. Now he's forced out right. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Different pass rushes are designed for different things. Sometimes you want to keep the quarterback in the pocket. Sometimes you want him to flush. I don't know exactly how this one was designed, but they made sure they moved him to his right. He got out of the pocket. Unfortunately for him, he was hit as he tried to throw the ball, and that resulted in an incompletion.
Here's Dalton. Underneath, this is Bernard. So he fought off the tackle, and that effort gives him the first before he's brought down. It's a gain of 13, and the Bengals have a first down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
Dalton throwing on 2nd down. Buying time to his left. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's 3rd down.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
It's 3rd and 4. Big play here, trying to keep this opening drive of overtime alive. They'll run it here with Bernard. And he's got enough for the first across midfield to the 48. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains. They go with the ground game, pick up the first, now in plus territory.
And that changes the whole mentality of a play caller, doesn't it? Once they cross the 50, they feel like they're in the strike zone, all right? You don't have to be in the red zone to take those big shots downfield or go after the end zone. Right now, that might be available to them.
And now this first drive in open. Giovanni Bernard, nothing but green grass. And he's into the end zone for the touchdown and a game winner in OT.